We have had 12,001 recoveries, and therefore we are remaining with 111 cases.
So far, at least 1,312 COVID-19 cases have been registered in prison facilities, and these include inmates and prison staff.
COVID has not spared us as prisons. The last time I told you we were at 1,200, now the number has jumped. By this morning, we had 1,312 cases which has emerged from prisons. Prisoners 1,175, staff 106, and staff relatives are 30.
Brigadier Flavia Biekwaso, the Army spokesperson, revealed that the force has received a number of complaints about Ugandans, mainly motorists, who violently attack security operatives who are on duty.
I'm using this opportunity to sound a warning, and a strong warning, to perpetrators of such acts that punitive measures shall be taken against them. The soldiers under such threats will have no option but to defend themselves. And this is very important, because we've had previously cases of why soldiers do this, why should soldiers have to shoot. But where soldiers are conducting their patrols, they are doing their work, and people are pelting stones at them.
Meanwhile, police spokesperson Fred Enanga warned all those ignoring the SOPs that tougher penalties await them.
We have reached a stage where these endless reminders must stop in exchange for stricter enforcement. Therefore, for emphasis, all our frontline officers have been given guidelines to follow at checkpoints and how to verify the barcodes on all stickers that have been issued by the Ministry of Works and Transport. So we are going to ensure that the ban on movements of public and private passenger transport like buses, taxis, borders, even private cars is enforced.
Enanga further warned those traders who are said to be organizing a protest against the countrywide lockdown. The traders are reportedly being incited by politicians. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.